Hi, my name is Andrew.
And my name is Keith, and this is T.E.C. 3001 by Phoenix. This is one of the summer uprising Xbox Live indie games, and it's currently my favorite so far of the trials that I've played.
All right. So, ooh, look at that. Even that is pretty fancy.
See, that's just cool. And overall, it's just a very nice looking game. Hard drive, select, okay.
Look at, he's doing the robot.
Iron Man. Basically, it's a, it's almost like a direct rip in many ways of a game called Rhythm Ribbon on the iPhone, which is from the people that made Tap Tap Revolution. Basically, you go along a linear path and try to go back and forth in order to get these various collectibles. Then you need a minimum amount in order to finish the level, but you also need to dodge every obstacle that you come across. And loading.
That's a lot of loading time.
Loading. Maybe it's a record loading on Xbox Live indie games. These get a little intrusive, but I guess they're necessary, but they never go away for the whole tutorial. Not game. The other word. Trial, there we go. Batteries collected. Press A to jump. It's a pretty game, pretty backgrounds, pretty everything. It's just nice. My only real gripe about the game is that the camera turns when you do, which...
Yeah, it looks to be really obnoxious.
It does get kind of disorienting. It seems like it might have been best to have the camera static and just pulled back a little bit so you have a good view of where you're weaving.
It makes it kind of hard.
Yeah.
So...
There's parts where I'm not sure which way to go in when I'm jumping at platforms.
Now it's green.
Green. Yeah, there's these gates that change the color of the world. Doesn't really do anything, but hey, colors. I like colors.
Charge.
Yeah, I didn't realize what that did at first, but you can charge. If you see a small transparent object, you can actually hit right trigger to charge through it.
That's awesome. You're like a beast. Oh.
And then you can jump, and then you can go into dead ends, and then you have a thing that tells you you're at a dead end. You're like, herpy derpy derp, and then I'm like, I'm going to jump over this. Yeah.
Yeah, into the death zone.
That's a good case of where a turning camera can really screw you over. Because I'm like, where do I stop? I don't know where I'm... I just turned at a 90-degree angle to the level. This doesn't end well.
Now are you going to run through the things?
Yep.
Gonna
repeat it a few times until I get this shit right. And you have to collect like I said before, you have to collect a minimum number of batteries in order to finish the level. Because I'm stupid. Also, I did. Aha!
Oh.
Doom.
Whoa. Wow, this game's like really trippy.
It's really fun too. It's just
you're going super.
It's just a satisfying game to play. Go!
It's like
go speed race, sir.
It's like you're playing a running game in the Matrix.
A running game in the Matrix, or like Lawnmower Man. You ever see that?
Yeah,
exactly. That's what it reminds me.
Oh, now there's trees and lightning.
Yeah,
it's getting surreal.
Starting to sort of go in this like Child of Eden realm, or Rez. Rez is actually a pretty good reference to make.
Do you know how many levels there are?
I have no idea. All I know is the difficulty started going up very quickly.
Really?
Yeah, the review that I read about this before I played said that he basically couldn't get past like the third level or fourth level or whatever level that I started having troubles with, he said that he couldn't beat. I get past it eventually, but it starts getting real fast, and there's a real cool sense of speed that I haven't really noticed since back when I used to play Need for Speed Most Wanted. Like just the right amount of motion blur and distortion, where like the entire world sort of stretches a little bit when you go faster.
Yeah. Oh.
Double jump.
Double jump extra.
And they start expecting some pretty specific patterns in order to clear certain areas.
Running toaster, Mr. Speedy. Seems like a very, very difficult game.
Oh, here it comes.
Pick up speed rather fast.
Yeah, I'd pick up speed faster if I was smart enough to hit the arrows.
Yeah, but it looks like you don't want to go too fast, I guess I could say. Like,
yeah.
I mean, it's good for the score, but it looks like almost until you get your bearings, you don't want to start being speed racer over here.
Yeah, it all depends on how much you're trying to get the, right trigger, jackass, what are you doing? I'm an idiot. I hate watching myself fail. At least I realized what arrows do this time. Come on.
Green gate gives you max speed.
Interesting choice to show you a tutorial screen this set.
Fuck?
Yeah, turns out
that was terrible.
Turns out that's a bad idea. That's pretty much a trap, right? Like,
well, I don't know. Hey, I think you can make it happen if you
go check out this super speed thing that'll catapult you into a series of obstacles that you need to jump over as fast as possible.
Or what it could do is it could prevent you from slowing down.
Yeah, there's probably a perfect. If you time it perfectly, you can probably clear all of it and just be way better than me. Whoa!
Like how the colors change as you get closer to it.
Yeah.
Oh, you pulled it a little close there.
We're definitely getting into the realm of what I was talking about earlier, where it just starts getting faster and faster and faster, and you just sort of.
Oh! Wow,
oh God! I want to edit that out, but we're not going to.
Whoa!
Yeah, this starts ending.
Oh, you ran right into it.
This starts just ending badly and embarrassingly for me. The speed reaches a point where it gets very difficult to react to anything that you're seeing, especially since the things are blurring. And
what do the batteries do?
Aside from score, of course, you need like a minimum number to win the level.
The batteries?
If you don't pick up enough, you lose when you beat the level.
That's not very fun. Oh shit!
Yeah, it's gonna take me a while to be smart enough to jump over that.
Good God! So yeah, this game does. It looks really fast-paced, really fun.
Yeah,
really
I was really impressed by this. Like as far as I wouldn't have been surprised to find a game like this on Xbox Live Arcade rather than just the indie store.
Yeah, I mean it's even well done, like graphics-wise, and I mean they keep, you know,
polished visual. God damn it! It's got a very polished visual aesthetic. If only I had polished gameplay, and not the game, me. You know, the thing where like, hey, there's a hole there. Maybe I should jump over it the fifth time.
Or just fall into the hole.
I'm just getting frustrated at this point and just randomly jumping off cliffs.
I can see that.
Yeah, I'm really proud of myself here. I'm glad we have recorded footage of me being an idiot. Come on,
slide.
I'm just glad that I never ran into the little tiny dividing line. I think just that. I think it's always the same length. Because I'm not holding it or anything.
Oh, you're just pressing.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, really. I think what happened, I was trying to count the number of slides I did, and I kept miscounting or something. Like I kept forgetting where the jump was. Because you don't see it until after you jump over the thing. And I was just... no reaction.
So, I guess for those at home watching, you now know how to get past this level.
Yeah!
I mean, it obviously you've seen it enough now that you know how to get past this with flying colors.
Be better than me, please. Please.
Whoa, you almost ran into a pole there.
Try reaching the end of the trial instead of reaching the time limit like I did.
Oh, snap, you did it! Red arrows will slow you down. Oh, that's not good.
Fail. Well, giant leap for mankind. That was TEC 3001 by Phoenix of the Summer of Arcade for 240 Microsoft points, and I definitely recommend it.